Welcome to another Tempestorm Meta Snapshot Breakdown. Following the latest balance change to Mindrender Alucia and Kael'thas Sunstrider, the meta has shifted slightly. While the decks targeted by the nerfs are still seeing a ton of play, toning down their power level has left room for other decks to compete with them on a more even playing field. You may be wondering how the meta has shifted since our last standard meta snapshot. Join us as we answer this question while diving deeper into the meta. As always, if you enjoy this look into the meta, be sure to leave a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel over here at Tempo Strategy. Now, without further ado, let's dive right into Tier 1. Leading off Tier 1 this time around is, well, Priest. In fact, Priest makes up the top two decks of the current format. While the nerf to Alucia might have slowed her down slightly, the archetype itself is still well-rounded enough that it continues to overperform most decks on the ladder. The deck at the very top of the meta is currently Galakrond Priest. This archetype is essentially the more consistent version of its Highlander counterpart, thanks to the ability to run duplicates within the deck. While the Highlander payoff cards are good, being able to run duplicates of the stronger cards allows Priest to win more consistently. Galakrond Priest continues to be one of the better decks against Animal Druid, as you can answer their threats while staving off their pressure. As for bad matchups, Bomb Control Warrior can be problematic, as the consistent damage and pressure can prove to be difficult to deal with. The second deck in Tier 1 this time around is the previously mentioned Highlander Priest. While some players were in disagreement about which Priest archetype was stronger, it seems to be that this one is very slightly less consistent than Galakrond Priest. They do have relatively similar matchup spreads, but Galakrond Priest seems to do slightly better in nearly all of them. Don't let this fool you though, Highlander Priest continues to be a solid ladder deck and is performing very well despite being a bit weaker than its duplicate-based counterpart. Highlander Priest has a solid matchup spread, but its best matchup is against Aggro Rogue, which is one of the only matchups where it performs better than the other Priest variant. Thanks to the more liberal deck build, you're able to run more weapon removal and niche removals in general, helping you with this matchup. In terms of bad matchups, Highlander Priest really dislikes facing off against Tempo Mage, as both their aggression and randomly generated spells can be very difficult for the Priest to deal with. The first non-Priest deck within Tier 1 this time around is Animal Druid. The list we're featuring is a hybrid list that leans into the Malagos package more in order to take advantage of the Priests and other slower decks on ladder. With the nerf to Kael'thas, players are typically heading in the direction of either Malagos for burst or Mount Cellar for pressure, and are usually seen removing Kael'thas from the deck. Animal Druid is still a solid ladder deck despite the nerf, so don't expect it to go anywhere. If you're interested in the Malagos build of this deck, we recently had a deck spotlight go up for it, so be sure to check it out. This variant of Animal Druid performs best against decks such as Tempo Warrior that struggle to deal with the immense amount of threats that you have. The difficult matchups for Animal Druid tend to stem from both different Priest archetypes and Bomb Control Warrior, as they can continually clear your board while pressuring you down once you're behind. The last deck making its appearance in Tier 1 this time around is Bomb Control Warrior. This archetype has made a surprising appearance and has been dominating the ladder to a surprising extent. While it's still not at the power level of the other Tier 1 decks, it's very possible that this deck rises to the top once a list is refined. Bomb Control Warrior spends the early turns clearing the board and ends the game by punching their opponent with Wrench Calibers or with any of its threats. This archetype of warrior has a solid matchup against some of the more popular decks on ladder, namely Tempo Mage and Soul Demon Hunter. When it comes to bad matchups though, Bomb Control Warrior struggles against the pressure Aggro Rogue has, and Tempo Warrior's nearly endless armor gain. Now that we've taken an in-depth look into Tier 1, let's take a peek at the top performing decks within the second tier. These archetypes are powerful and solid choices for ladder, but are a bit less consistent than their Tier 1 counterparts. We definitely suggest trying them out if you want to stray off the beaten path a bit. Leading off Tier 2 is Aggro Rogue. This list being featured is a hybrid of the stealth and weapon variants, and is sure to satisfy your aggressive itch. If you enjoy aggro decks, then this is the list for you. Aggro Rogue shows simply how strong Secret Passage is, and lets you make use of it in order to generate as much consistent pressure as possible. Aggro Rogue has a good matchup against Tempo Mage and Bomb Control Warrior, as they struggle with the consistent early pressure. Rogue has a really bad matchup against Tempo Warrior though, as the risky skippers can single-handedly end the game with either board clears or armor gain. Next up in Tier 2 is the previously discussed Tempo Warrior. This archetype has been doing well, but still requires a skilled pilot in order to truly shine. This is one of the more difficult decks in the meta currently, but if you played it a lot before the expansion, it shouldn't take you long to perfect your play. Tempo Warrior takes advantage of some of the more aggressive decks on ladder, such as Aggro Rogue, due to the consistent board clears coupled with the large armor gain that is available. On top of this, the deck can also have relatively large swing turns, locking many decks out of the game. When it comes to Tempo Warrior's bad matchup, the deck seems to be struggling against both Animal Druid and Galakrond Priest. This is the main reason that Warrior does not find itself higher on the tier list, as two of the most popular ladder decks farm it consistently. The final deck we'll be taking a look at today is Soul Demon Hunter. This is a new take on the once popular Control Demon Hunter, but opts to run the Soul Fragment synergies in order to be more well-rounded. These cards allow you to wipe the board, heal yourself, and even push damage. This archetype has been gaining popularity after players had success with it on the Chinese servers, so expect it to gain traction in the coming weeks. Its best matchup comes from Aggro Rogue and Tempo Demon Hunter, as you can easily stave off their pressure while healing through their burn. As for bad matchups, Tempo and Bomb Control Warrior prove to be difficult, as they can out-armor your pressure, making it difficult for you to close out the game. Soul Demon Hunter is a versatile archetype that you will need a specific meta for it to succeed, but it seems as if we're heading towards that meta. In order to counter the meta, you should look to target as many tier 1 decks as possible. It can be hard at times to hit several different archetypes, but this time around we have a very spicy deck for you to try out. Turtle Mage gained traction upon its inception, but seemingly fell out of the meta after a few days. The deck might struggle in some matchups, especially with how difficult it can be to play, but once perfected, the deck really preys on not only the two priest archetypes in tier 1, but also Bomb Control Warrior. It can be really challenging to learn this deck, but trust us, the payoff will be well worth it. While it might struggle with Druid, we sincerely suggest trying this deck out. Let us know in the comments below how it does for you. The Skolomance Academy meta has been changing weekly, but it seems we're finally at a relatively stable point. Until we see a brand new deck pop up or a set of balance changes, expect the meta to remain somewhat similar to what it is now. How are you enjoying the latest Hearthstone expansion? We here at Tempo Storm have been having a blast and are seriously addicted to the game right now. Before we wrap up, we'd like to remind you to subscribe to our channel and to leave a like to support us if you enjoyed this video. It helps us more than you know, and we truly do appreciate it. We wish you the best of luck on Ladder, and we'll see you next time.